Hello everyone, I welcome you all for today's session on power system stability and its classification. First, let us try to understand what is meant by the power system stability. And for this, I have taken a very simple system where we have a single generator and a single load. So the power will be transferred from a generator to the load through transmission line. So the system is said to be under balanced condition whenever the generation is equal to the load. We know in AC system, the power represents the complex power. So you can say the power generated by the generator is equal to Sg, that is equal to summation of real power plus reactive power. Similarly, if you talk about the power received by the load, which is equal to power demand, that is equal to real power demand plus reactive power demand. So this condition implies that the real power generation should be equal to the real power demand. Similarly, the reactive power generation should be equal to the reactive power demand. So if these two conditions satisfies, you can say the system is perfectly under balanced condition, or you can say the system is stable. If you come to the practical condition, it is very difficult to maintain these two relations. Due to the variations in certain parameters, there will be some changes in the real power and the reactive power. The stability is related to only the components, the real power and reactive power. There will be some parameters which may be dependent on these quantities indirectly. So what are those values? So let us see, stability depends on which quantities. The stability of the system defined with respect to three quantities majorly. One is voltage, frequency and rotor angle del. So if you see here, nowhere we could see the terms real power and reactive power. Just now we have seen that if you maintain a balance between the power generation and the demand with respect to these quantities, then the system will be stable. But whatever the stability we are going to study is defined with respect to these three parameters. Means there is a relation between these quantities and these quantities. Let us see what is that relation. The changes in the real power causes the changes in the frequency, and the changes in the reactive power causes the changes in the voltage magnitude. Then you may ask, okay, we have two parameters and here the stability is divided with respect to three parameters. And fine, we got two relations, that is frequency varies with respect to the real power changes and the voltage with respect to the reactive power changes. Then how this load angle is going to vary? So we know that the generator, whatever we are using in the generating stations, is nothing but a synchronous generator. So synchronous generator, also called as an alternator. And we know the synchronous speed NS is equal to 120 F by P. The changes in the frequency causes the changes in the speed of the rotor. So the change in the speed of the rotor causes the change in the load angle del. So thereby indirectly the changes in the real power causes the change in the frequency and the load angle del. So therefore, if we control these three parameters in the system, then we can operate the system always in a stable condition. Okay, the next question is, what is meant by controlling? Is there any reference for us? Okay, if the voltage lies within these limits, then we can say that the system is under balanced condition, or within the, we have controlled the voltage. And then what about the frequency limits? What about the load angle limits? some boundaries we should have, right? So if the voltage fall in this range, then it is perfectly a balanced condition. Frequency should fall in this range and the load angle should be this much only. So if you know those values, then you can say that your system is operating under stable condition. If it is going beyond those limits, then you can say that the system is moving to the unstable condition. So we should have some reference to check whether we are operating the system under balanced condition or not. So let us see what are those limits for these three parameters. The voltage should be within plus or minus 5%. That means if you represent the voltage in the per unit, the voltage should lie between 0.95 per unit to 1.05 per unit. So this is the lower limit and this is the upper limit. So less than this we should not go and beyond this we should not move. So if the voltage is falling below 0.95 and above 1.05 is not recommendable, that means the system is not under stable condition. Similarly, coming to the frequency, so the frequency ranges will be plus or minus 1%, which is 49.5 Hz to 50.5 Hz. Coming to the load angle del, del should be always less than the del maximum value. So if you satisfy all these conditions while operating the system, then we can say the system is under balanced condition. But practically, one or the other parameter will be going beyond the limits due to some external disturbances or you may the switching operations. So let us see one example, what could be the reason to violate the limits. Again, the same condition we are taking, we are going to supply a load by considering only one generator. Suppose the load demand increases suddenly where the generation is not able to meet the load demand. So then what is the condition? This is the situation where the system may lead to the unstable condition. To avoid this, we should provide or we should increase the extra power generation so that you will meet the required load demand. Suppose we have reached the maximum capacity of the generator. To understand this, let us consider the initial load demand is 5 megawatt and the initial generating capacity, let me say 7 megawatt. So 5 megawatt I could able to supply because the capacity of the first generator is considered as a 7 megawatt. Suppose the load has increased to the 10 megawatt. So now my new load demand is 10 megawatt. So I can increase up to 7 megawatt from the first generator. Even if I increase the full capacity of the generator also, I am not able to meet the power demand. Then the balance between the generation and the demand will be no more maintained. Now I am lack of 3 megawatt of the power. To get this 3 megawatt, what we have to do? Our system is an interconnected system. That means we can operate several generators in parallel to meet the required demand. So I am going to bring one more generator to supply this extra 3 megawatt. You would have studied that the synchronization of the generator. So how to synchronize, how to bring a new generator to the operation. So means while connecting that, we should make sure that the two generators should have the same frequency and the same voltage. Now you can put this into the operation by closing the switches. So then this generator, now we could able to produce that 3 megawatt to the load. So that is how we will meet the required load. Suppose the load demand increases even more. So this generating capacity is also not adequate to supply. So like that we continue to bring several generators into the operation by synchronizing the incoming generators to the already operating system. So this is how we will connect the practical system to meet a certain load. These all generators will be running under synchronism. Suppose if any fault occurs at the transmission line or at the generator terminals due to these fault, so there will be some disturbances. That means Some generators may accelerate, some generators may decelerate depending upon the fault condition. It is not possible sometimes to run all the generators in synchronism. So thereby there will be a chance of moving out of step. Out of step is nothing but losing the synchronism. So or coming out of the synchronism. So the system stability or the power system stability is stated as the ability of the system to maintain the synchronism. Later they have modified this statement in a different way. So first let us know what is the reason to modify the statement. The system may lead to the instability condition without losing the synchronism. So due to some control techniques, so we may not let these generators lose the synchronism. Due to the fault in the other part of the power system, the system may move to the unstable condition. Okay. Then if you say the stability is only with respect to the synchronous point of view, we cannot satisfy this condition. That means the system may be moved to the unstable but without losing the synchronism. So therefore they have restated the power system stability as the ability of the system to regain a balanced condition after subjected to a disturbance. Means once the system is subjected to the fault, if it is able to come back to the normal condition, then you can say the system is under balanced condition. Now let us see what is meant by a disturbance. A disturbance is nothing but a fault or a sudden load changes, or you can say the tripping or the outages of the transmission lines or the generators. So these disturbances are categorized into two different types in the stability studies, that is large disturbances and the small disturbances. So let us see which and all disturbances will fall under the category of small disturbances and which and all fall under the category of large disturbances. Small disturbances are nothing but the switching operation of the small loads. What is meant by the switching operation? On and the off of the small loads. So that is switching on and off of the small loads will fall under small disturbance. Similarly, the tripping of the transmission lines and the small generator tripping. You can say what is meant by the small generator tripping. So generally the renewable energy sources will fall under the small generators category. So if any these generators tripping occurs, then that also will be act as a small disturbance to the system. Now let us see the large disturbances. So the large disturbances are nothing but faults. You know, we have studied several faults, that is shunt fault and the series fault, symmetrical and the unsymmetrical fault. All these faults will fall under the category of a large disturbance to the system. Similarly, the switching operation of the large loads and the tripping of the large generators. So which and all will come under the large generators? Large generators are nothing but the conventional generators. So that is coal and the hydro, nuclear, all these generators where it will take a base loads. In that context, the small generators are nothing but the generators which are taking the peak loads. Now coming to the classification of the power system stability. The power system stability is majorly classified into three types. So first one is rotor angle stability and frequency stability and the voltage stability. So we have seen already the rotor angle stability further classified into two types. One is steady state stability, another is transient stability. The steady state stability refers to the small disturbances and the transient stability represent the large disturbances. Coming to the voltage stability also like rotor angle stability, we have two types. So one is the small disturbance voltage stability and the large disturbance voltage stability. Now with respect to the time frame, The steady state stability and the transient stability will fall under the category of a short term, and the frequency stability and the voltage stability will fall under the category of short term as well as long term. So in the upcoming slides, we are going to discuss about each and every term which is mentioned here. Let us start with the rotor angle stability. The rotor angle stability is nothing but the ability of the system to remain in synchronism even after subjected to a disturbance. So I have told you already, the rotor angle del should be less than the del max. So during the disturbance condition, the del may change and del may move towards the del max value. Suppose initially the del is operating somewhere, due to the disturbance it will start moving towards this del max. Before violating or before losing the synchronism, if we are able to bring the system back to the synchronism, then you can say the system will be under stable condition. Now let us see, depends on which parameter the rotor angle is going to depend. So the rotor angle depends basically on two quantities. One is electromagnetic torque and another one is mechanical torque. This electromagnetic torque is related to the electrical power output PE, and the mechanical torque is related to the mechanical input, or you can say that shaft power. Why? Because we know the relation between the power and the torque. Power is equal to torque into omega, that is the angular speed of the rotor. So you can say here TE into omega. So here also the shaft power is equal to mechanical torque into angular speed of the rotor. So these two will be acting in the opposite direction. Whenever there is a balance between the electromagnetic torque and the mechanical torque, so the rotor angle will run smoothly, so without any problem. If there is any changes in these two quantities, then there will be a changes in the rotor angle. Due to any external disturbance or due to any fault, if the balance between the electromagnetic torque and the mechanical torque disturbed, so what will happen now? It causes huge fluctuations in the rotor. So there will be oscillations in the rotor, which will further lead to the unstable condition. So now let us see the steady state stability and the transient stability. The steady state stability is nothing but it is the ability of the system to remain in synchronism when subjected to a small disturbance. So we know that these two stabilities will fall under the rotor angle stability, and the rotor angle stability is nothing but it is maintaining the synchronism. So similarly, these two statements also will have a common statement, that it is the ability of maintaining the synchronism. Only the difference is which type of fault it is subjecting. So whenever it is subjected to small disturbance, then you can say that steady state stability. So the transient stability is nothing but the ability of the system to remain in synchronism when subjected to a large disturbance. The steady state stability concept can be understood by using the concept swing equation. Similarly, we can understand the transient stability using the equal area criterion concept. The steady state stability, time of operation, within how much of time we could able to take the necessary actions with respect to these stabilities, means it varies from 0.1 second to the 10 seconds. This also varies from 0.1 second to 10 seconds. Therefore, steady state stability and transient stability will fall under the category of short term. So what is meant by short term? If the time frame is only a fraction of seconds, so these kind of studies will fall under the short term. Now coming to the voltage stability, it is the ability of the system to maintain steady state voltage at all the system buses when subjected to a disturbance. So very, very important. What is meant by system buses? First, let us try to understand this point. Let us take this single line diagram. Here, these two are called bus. Is there any special name for this, or both will be called as a bus means? So in the power system point of view, you can see where that particular bus has connected. If that bus is connected with respect to the generator, that means if the generator is connected to that bus, then you can call it as a generator bus. If the load is connected to any bus, then that will be called as a load bus. A bus is nothing but where the incoming and the outgoing lines will be taken. So you can say that a node. Approximately how many buses we may have in the system? Whenever we are doing the analysis, you may take it as a 20 bus system or 30 bus system, 50 bus system and 100 bus system also we can take and analyze. So that means if you are taking 50 buses like this, is it possible to maintain at all the buses voltage within the range of 0.95 to 1.05? Is it possible? If it is possible, then you can say the system is a stable condition. That is what this statement says. Ability of the system to maintain steady state voltages. What are the steady state voltages are here? Steady state voltages we are taking, the voltage should lie within this range. If the voltage falls between this range at all the 50, whatever how many buses we are taking, either it is a 50 buses or 100 buses, if all the buses could able to maintain the voltage within this range, then you can say the system is stable with respect to voltage. Let me tell you one more thing. Here, the steady state stability is also called as small signal stability. Small signal stability or small disturbance stability. And the transient stability will be called as a large signal stability or large disturbance stability. Likewise, the voltage stability also will be represented as a large voltage stability if it is subjected to a large disturbance, and the small voltage stability if it is subjected to a small disturbances. Now coming to the time frame, we have seen that the voltage stability will fall under the short term as well as the long term. Let us see which type of disturbances will fall under the short term category. If the voltage fluctuations occur due to the fast acting devices, for example, the power electronic devices and the high voltage DC transmission systems or the induction motors, so the operating time will be between the 10 seconds to the 20 seconds duration. Now coming to the long term, which takes 1 minute to the couple of minutes, this will fall under if the voltage fluctuations causes because of the slow changes in the load or the overloading of the lines or the overloading of the generator reactive power limits and the tap changing transformers. Coming to the frequency stability, it is the ability of the system to maintain steady frequency following a disturbance between a generation and the load. We have seen that the frequency depends upon the real power. If there is a mismatch between the power demand and the power generation, then there will be a change in the frequency. So that is what he is telling. If there is a disturbance between the generation and the load, so under that condition also, if we are able to maintain the steady frequency, now we should know what is meant by steady frequency. The steady frequency is nothing but if you are able to maintain the frequency between 49.5 to 50.5. So there will be some up and downs will be there. Okay, the power demand may be a slight variation will be there all the time. So the demand will be keep increasing and decreasing. So according to that, the frequency also will be varying around 50 hertz. So it will be going to 49.9, 49.8, 49.7, like that 49.5. Similarly, it will start raising 51.5, 51.2, like that in the upper limit. If the frequencies fall in this range, the system will be in a stable condition. If there is any disturbance which is causing to move the frequency beyond this limit, then the system may lead to the unstable condition, or you can say instability. Now let us see on which parameters the frequency depends. The frequency stability depends on the ability to restore equilibrium between generation and the load. If you are able to bring back the equilibrium between the generation and the load, that means the demand. If the demand increasing, according to the demand, we should able to increase the generation, then the frequency will come back to the 50 Hertz. If the demand is decreasing, and if you could able to divert this power generation to the other area where the power generation is required, because if the demand increases, you can increase the power generation by increasing the input to the prime mover. But if the power demand decreases, already you have fed some input. So input you cannot take back. Once you have given the input, it is difficult to revert back the input. If you want, you can feed the input extra to generate the power. So what best you can do in this condition? So we can just transfer that excess amount of power wherever required that power, because it is the interconnection where you can control the power, you can give the power or you can take power from the neighbor states or the neighbor regions by using the tie lines. So by performing these operations, then you can bring back the equilibrium between the generation and the load. Now let us talk about these two points with respect to the short term and the long term. So which and all conditions will fall under the short term? Whether the first condition will fall, what is the first condition? If power demand increases, increasing the power generation. Second condition is, if power demand decreases, diverting this input power to the other areas. Let us see which method will fall under the category of short term and the long term. We know that the short term is nothing but which is going to happen in the fraction of seconds. It will happen if it is a under frequency control. That is, the second condition fall under the category of this short term. So that means if the power demand decreases, by using the tie lines, quickly you can send the power to the other regions so that you can bring back the equilibrium condition in the system. Now coming to the long term. Long term will take several minutes. That means corresponding to the response of the devices like the prime mover. That means if there is any increase in the power demand, you should recognize and you should feed the input to the prime mover. So as soon as you feed the coal, we cannot produce within fraction of seconds the steam. So it will take some few minutes to come into the operation and take up that extra load. So that is why these kind of operations will fall under the category of the long term. Suppose we fail to take precautions or the necessary actions to bring back the frequencies to the normal condition within a given time span. What will happen? The frequency instability leads to the sustained frequency swings in the system. The frequency is related to the speed. So the speed will be related to the rotor angle. So it will cause the rotor angle start swinging around the synchronous speed, and it will further leads to the tripping of the generating units and the loads. At one point, if the load angle move certain angle, so then it will fall out of the step. Corresponding loads also will fall out of the step. These are the effects due to the instability of the frequency. Now, let us try to understand the relation between the different stabilities. We have three different types of stabilities: voltage, angle, and the frequency stability. So, first we should understand Is there any effect of the voltage instability on the frequency stability and the angle stability? So similarly, is there any relation between these two? That means the varying or the instability condition of one parameter causes any effect on the other parameters, or these events are independent. Let us see. The voltage collapses may lead to the large disturbances in the rotor angle. So, the changes in the voltages may also causes the disturbance in the rotor angle. Similarly, these voltage collapse may also lead to the large disturbances in the frequency too. Therefore, the voltage instability may cause or the may lead disturbances with respect to the rotor angle as well as the frequency also. Similarly, the large frequency deviations may also lead to the large changes in the voltage magnitude. So, the voltage may cause changes in the frequency and the angle, and the changes in the frequency may also disturb the voltage at the buses. So, therefore, these stabilities are not the independent events. So, these are interrelated to each other. So, the disturbance occur in one parameter, it may lead to the disturbances in the other parameters also. So, therefore, to maintain the system stability, we need to maintain all these parameters should fall within the required limits. So, that is, the voltage should be within 0.95 to 1.05 and the frequency should be 49.5 to 50.5 and the angle should be less than del max. If we could able to maintain these parameter within these limits, then always the system will be in stable condition. I hope it is clear. Still, if you have any doubt, please let me. Thank you.